वेलकम टू शांति पीसफुल मैथमेटिक्स। सो होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल इन दिस पेंडामिक सिचुएशन। इन दिस सेमेस्टर आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस सब्जेक्ट कॉल्ड एडवांस कैलकुलस। अ कैलकुलस यू लर्न इन योर 12th स्टैंडर्ड, ऑल्सो इन योर FYBSC क्लास। So in that we have learned about what is Rolle's mean value theorem, what will be the series of, what is the limit, continuity, differentiability of function of one variables, and there are certain applications of functions of one variable. Basically calculus is established to develop the few questions. The first question, to solve the first question, is the finding the instantaneous rate of change. The second question is to finding the maxima and minima and finding the area of uneven shapes. So finding such questions, we need to learn about the calculus. Here the subject name is the advanced calculus. So what the all sort of things you have did in your 12th standard as well as in your FYBSC class, you are dealing with all sort of the questions in for the functions of one variable. So in this semester we are going to discuss the advanced calculus and finding the all sort of the questions for functions of more than one variable. That means the functions of two variable, three variable, and all sort of things. So let us discuss what is the detailed syllabus for this. So in the first unit you have the limit and continuity of the function of several variables. So in that, first of all, we'll gives you introduction about what is a function of several variable. See, the functions of several variable are very important because in your surrounding everything is changing due to not only one variable. It is happening due to many variable. For example, the temperature is there. So temperature is changing not only for sun, it is also depends on how much humidity is there, what will be the pollution of surrounded area, and all sort of the variables is cause of a temperature of the surrounded by you. So the functions of several variable actually very very important to study certain phenomena, certain real life application. For example, you can go for eating a muskaban. So why the muskaban's price is that much which you are paying? Because it depends on the price of bun, what it is cost of whatever the bun is, and the cost of bun or a price of bun is also depends on what will be the procedure, what is the floor price is there. Also it is also depends on what is the price of muska means a butter, what will be the price of a butter. So according to that, the cost of the muskaban is also depends on many variables. So in that way, in economics, in physics, in statistics, the functions of study of functions variable is very very important. So that's why we are dealing with certain things here. So functions of several variable, that is the first introduction that we are going to discuss. Next, we are discussing about the neighborhoods of point in Rn. Rn means it is an n-dimensional space that you probably have know about that. So R square you know, because you know about the two-dimensional spaces, three-dimensional spaces, and then in that same manner we'll have a n-dimensional spaces. Then we'll talk about the limit of such functions. So that means the limit of functions of several variable. We already know what is the limit of functions of one variable. We'll learn about what is the limit of functions of several variable. We'll talk about the continuous function. So you know what is a continuous functions for one variable. Here we are talking about the continuous functions for many variables. Then we'll talk about the iterative limits. We'll talk about the limit will be depends on path, and so it is a path dependent limit or independent limit, and continuity is already spoke about. So we'll, in the unit 1 we have study about the functions, limit, and continuity is there. Unit 2 that we have is the differentiability, is deal with the differentiability of the functions of several variables. Know about what you mean by differentiable functions. That means a limit, if you have a function is defined over a to r, where a is a subset of r, that means it is a real valued function defined on a real variable, then you know that the differentiable function is limit of f of x minus f of a upon x minus a, limit of this will be exist, then we can say that f is differentiable at x is equal to a. Okay, but what should be the definition for functions of one variable? That means this x is now many variables is there. This a is also many components are there. So what should be the definition of differentiable functions for functions of several variables? That we are talking about that. So for that we required some introduction about the partial derivatives. So that is the first thing we are talking about, the partial derivative. Partial derivatives is word itself suggests something. It is a partially derivative. And what is the geometrical interpretation of that? We also discuss about that. We'll discuss about what is the higher order partial derivatives. Then we'll talk about the differentiability of functions of two variables. So we make ourselves only for functions of two variable for differentiability. We'll talk about some theorems on differentiability. Important is called the Squaw's theorem, and another one is the Young's theorem. These two theorems on mixed derivatives. The unit 3 is based on differentiability, that is a part 2 differentiability. In that we are talking about the what is the differentiable functions for two variable. We'll talk about the chain rule. As you know, the chain rule in for functions of one variable for differentiability you have. Here is also we have a chain rule. Then we'll talk about the derivative of implicit function. Implicit function means the function is of the form f of x, y, z equal to 0. So that means this function you can convert into z in terms of some functions of x, y. And vice versa, we can talk about x is equal to some functions of y and z and so on. So that is called the implicit function. What would be the derivative of such functions? We'll talk about the homogeneous function. See, a homogeneous differential equation you have learned in your FIBAC class. What is the homogeneous differential equation? When you have dy by dx is equal to f of xy, if this function is homogeneous function, then we can say that this differential equation is homogeneous. What do you mean by homogeneous function? F of tx ty equal to t power n f of xy, for every xy if it is true, then we know that this is called the homogeneous function. So we'll discuss about what is the homogeneous functions and its further properties of that. With that we have also, there is very famous theorem is related to homogeneous function. It's called the Euler's theorem, that we are going to discuss in this for homogeneous function obviously. Then we are talking about the extreme values, which is actually application of functions of several variable or applications of differentiability is there. Basically that question that we are talking about, that finding the maxima and minima. So if the functions of many variable is there, which is gives you a real value, and what will be the extreme value for that? We'll talk about the extreme values of the function, how to calculate the extreme values, and in that there is one method is called the Lagrange multiplier method. So that also we are talking about. So that's it for the unit 3. Now we'll talk about the unit 4. So unit 4 is the application of partial derivative. We already talked about what is the partial derivative above. So it is a partially the derivative of the function, because the functions have many variables. So there are one variable, two variables. So we are differentiating a function with one variable and taking other variables as a constant. That is called the partial derivatives. And the applications of partial derivatives are finding the series of a given function. So we are talking about the Taylor series for functions of many variables. or it's known as a Taylor's theorem for functions of two variables. Maclaurin series we are talking about. See, my Maclaurin series and Taylor series for functions of one variable you've already studied in your semester 2. So here we are talking about the Taylor series and Maclaurin series for functions of two variable and more. We are talking about the multiple points. Next thing, next application is a multiple points. What do you mean by multiple points? If you have some curve and one curve is passes through one point with the more than two branch. For example, if you have this curve and you are moving towards and coming back from the same point, then at this point there are two branch of this curve is intersect. So that is the first one is this branch, another one is this branch. So such points are called the multiple points. So there are types of multiple points is there. And what are the types of multiple points are there and how the this applications of partial derivatives affect that, that we will learn about. Then we are talking about the radius of curvature. Again, this will be the application of the partial derivatives, or I can say a calculus. Why? Because radius of curvature is nothing but the how the rate of change of a tangent is there. So if you have this curve and here what will be the tangent, you can draw here what will be the tangent. So what will be the this rate of change of the tangent is there. So that is known as the radius of curvature. And we'll talk about the radius of curvature for parametric equation, Euler equations and all sort of things. Also we'll talk about some application in the geometry that we have, that is to find out the tangent plane and normal line to the surface. Okay, so that is the application in the geometry you have. These are the units you have in to study in this paper. We are following the two books here. The first one is the Mathematical Analysis by S.C. Malik and Savita Arora. This is a new age publication is there for this, and another one is a Differential Calculus by Santi Narayan. I may also suggest one more book here, that is called the B.S. Grewal, Higher Engineering Mathematics by B.S. Grewal. So we'll follow these books, and obviously the very, these are the Indian author book. There is a one foreign author books is there. It is called the Advanced Calculus Volume 1 and 2. By T.M. Apostol. This is very nice book for those who want a very fundamental idea, go with that. They should go with that. And all above three books are Indian author books. So I will suggest you can go with the Apostol book. But for reference, you can use the other three books which I have suggested. So that's it for today's lecture. Please do subscribe the YouTube channel Shanti Peace for Mathematics, because some of the video maybe I am making as a private videos. So those who are subscribers, they only can see this. So that's it for today. Thank you very much.